Hey friends, welcome back. It's Danielle. Today I have my Q&A video for you and I'm very excited to bring this to you. If you do have any other questions, please leave those in the comments below. You can also message me or email me. I will have all that info in the description box below. So let's get started with number one from Bethany. She asked me to do a quick video explaining sinking funds. So the quick video is, sinking funds are a small amount of money that you set aside for a specific purpose, and you can do that in cash or a checking account. Tyler and I decided to do that in a checking account. So we have lots of different checking accounts. We have 12 total. And so one of those is our regular checking account. One of those holds our $1,000 emergency fund, and the rest are all for sinking funds. So things like Christmas, car repairs, medical emergencies, and insurance. So we only pay our insurance premium once every 6 months. So rather than paying that when it's due, all out of one or two paychecks, we save up every single month, and then we save up an equal amount over those 6 months, and then we pay it all at once. That way we get a good discount from our insurance provider. So also things like Christmas. Christmas comes once a year, but rather than paying for it once a year, we save up for it all year, and then we pay for it when we have, you know, when we want to buy something. Also, if we come across something in October, we don't have to be scrambling for money. We can go ahead and buy something for that person, and we're good to go. So do it in a checking account, save it all up in cash, whatever, but that's all a sinking fund is. It's just a small amount of savings for something. Okay, so second question, is from Sandra. What are you reading in terms of personal growth and religious materials? So I can't speak for Tyler, but you guys know we do use a service called Scribd. It's an app that you can get on your phones, tablets, you can go on the website and read that way. We get plenty of books from that, but I am not religious at all, so I don't read any religious materials. As for what we're looking at in terms of personal growth, I have read Rachel Cruze's new book, Dave Ramsey books, but other than that, for me, reading is pretty much just a fun topic. I don't do a whole lot of reading outside of, you know, entertainment books. Now, I will read like articles and things like that. I've read a lot of stuff on the ketogenic diet. I looked up 3 or 4 books about that, but you know, I kind of skimmed through them and I didn't really find them to be as helpful as just Google searching some things. So for personal growth, I typically will just search an article or something like that. Sean and Lisa, how do you like your new job? And the new place, and do you have budget meetings with Tyler? So let me answer the first two. The new job is great. It's very busy. I like that. I hate being bored at work, so this one's great. The new place, it's working out very well. Now, sometimes the people above us, we do live in an apartment complex now, so the people above us will play music and stuff like that, and I can't record videos when they're playing music because, you know, that's copyright infringement if that can be heard in the background. So it does kind of, you know, cut down on my filming time, but, you know, we like it. It's a good amount of space. It's set up very well. Everything works. So that's always nice. The last place we were at, these people wouldn't fix anything. Our dishwasher ended up going out like 3 months before we moved, and they didn't fix it. It was just a whole mess. So, I'm happy that we have a dishwasher and it works and everything else works. So that's always good. And do we have budget meetings with Tyler? Sometimes I do and sometimes I don't. Basically, Tyler just knows he has a personal budget and he tries to stay within that. Other than that, I do all of the grocery shopping because I work less hours than him. I live 15 minutes from work. His work is an hour away. So, you know, I have a lot more free time even if we're working the same amount of hours, strictly because his drive is so much longer than mine. So I typically do the grocery shopping. Now we will go together sometimes, but in this new house, he's never went by himself. So, you know, I know the food budget. I know the restaurant budget. If we go to restaurants, we go together. If he has been going to restaurants too much, I'll say, hey, stop going to restaurants so much. pack extra for lunch or something like that. So that happens. But Every now and then, like I'll kind of get stressed out about the numbers or something like that, and I'll have him sit down with me and say, "Hey, go over this budget with me. Make sure I'm not missing anything," especially when we moved because we have bills from the old house still coming in, bills from the new house that are, when are they going to be due? When's the first bill due? You never know. So, we've been talking about money a lot more because of that. But typically he just kind of like spends what I tell him. So, homemaking with Tina. Did you transfer jobs when you moved? Yes, I did. So I used to have two jobs. One of them wasn't close enough to where we live now. So, I didn't transfer with one of them. I just resigned from that job and now I only have one job. Trisha said, "Didn't you just move in?" Yes, kind of. So, from the last house, from this current house until, what am I trying to say here? The last house we were in, we lived in for 12 months, pretty much exactly, like 11 months and a week or something like that. So we were only there a year. The place for before that was about 10 months, and the place before that was 6. And that's when we moved in together. So, I've done a lot of moving, a whole lot of moving, and Tyler's done one less move than me in the past few years, but it's been fun. I don't mind moving. I don't feel any sort of like need to live in any sort of certain place. Now there are places I've wanted to get away from because they were crappy last house. But I don't feel any sort of need to like live in a certain city or anything like that. I like moving. So it's fine. Shonda, how do you keep track of the total amount you have in your sinking funds? So our sinking funds are in a checking account. It's labeled with a name on it, and we just look at our bank account. We log in one time to our bank account, and all of our sinking funds, as well as our checking and our emergency fund, is there on one page. So it's super easy to keep up with, and everybody has an app now, so it's right there on our phones. Kayla, how did you and Tyler meet? We met at work. We actually used to work for HH Gregg. And so, funny story about this, if you guys don't already know, HH Gregg is going out of business. Now they're like an East Coast, like east of the Mississippi type company. They didn't venture west, so you may not know who they are, and they're not certainly not outside the United States, but they had about like 223 stores at their largest, and we met while working there. And when they announced they were going out of business, we still have lots of friends that had worked there previously and were connected with them on Facebook and different things like that. And it was I was just really, really glad that we started paying off our debts and we got an emergency fund, because if he and I were still working there making what we were making, or even more if we had been making a little bit more, but if we were still living like we were living, 20, what did we start out, like $48,000 in debt with no savings whatsoever, living paycheck to paycheck, and we found out our company was closing, we would be beyond buried. We would be just so out of luck on that, because they found out, that the company was closing, and then within, I think, 8 weeks, they're going to not have a job anymore. And that's just, it's amazing to me, and it kind of like made me so grateful that we found the Dave Ramsey plan, and that I do these videos, and that we have savings, and that we've paid off $19,000 in debt, So, to me, it just solidified why I do this. Why I want to be out of debt so bad, because you just never know what can happen. It might be out of your control. So that's where we met. If we didn't have debt, will we still be on a tight budget, or will we be more free and open with our spending? Once we are out of debt, I do want a healthy emergency fund. I want a full 6 months. I would not be happy with 3 because of the reasons I just explained. I've gone a month without a job before in between moves and different things like that. So, I want to get that emergency fund, but it's just, like how we're saving up for the wedding now, and we're still trying to pay off debt. It's going to be the same kind of balance. We're going to have a life balance as well as a savings balance. And seeing money in the bank account is just fun for me. So I really want to do that. And then, I mean, we're going to up our personal budget, but we're still going to have a budget for sure. We're still going to try to save in any way that we can on anything that we buy, even if we have a lot of money to buy it with. There's no reason not to try to save money. So, was Tyler always on board with the whole budgeting thing? And if not, how did you get him on board? So we started dating in October, during the month of October, and then by the next September of the next year, we had started budgeting together. And I always sort of had like, okay, well, we have this much money to spend for the next 2 weeks until we get paid. This is what we can spend, but we didn't do a budget whatsoever. Like, that wasn't something we did. So when we started budgeting, and Tyler had money to spend and he didn't have to eat like bologna sandwiches, he didn't have to be worried at where his next meal was going to come from because he overspent buying video games and didn't have enough money for food a month later. And then had to sell those video games. Different instances like that where you would overspend on something like totally frivolous, but then not have money to pay like your real bills. He didn't have that worry anymore, and he realized that extremely quickly. So he was totally on board with having a good meal and being able to not have that stress in his life anymore from not being able to pay bills. So once you start budgeting, and then that's why I do a budget for 1 month, and then I do like a preview or a rough draft budget for the next month after that, because we always want to kind of look ahead and make sure we're gonna have enough money to pay our bills. And then we can go back and say, okay, we're gonna have enough money to pay our bills. Let's have some spending money this month, or something like that. How do you stick to your budget, and how do you not buy other things when you go to the store? So when we go to the store, we do sometimes, a lot of times, buy something that's not on the list. We do make a grocery list 9 times, probably more, not more than 9 times out of 10 that we go shopping, probably like 98% of the time we go with the list. But then like, how do we not buy those other things? We just kind of say to ourselves, okay, well, do we really need this? Especially with the new diet, it really cuts down on entire aisles of stores. Like, we don't even have to go down certain aisles anymore because, there's nothing on that aisle we can buy. We don't go down the cereal aisle. We just don't, and it's not like something we're missing. It makes grocery shopping faster, and we're spending about the same as we were spending before. So when we have like a set food list that we can have on the diet, and then we have a list that we want to buy for certain meals that we're going to make. So that's how we kind of stay away from buying extraneous things. Now, if we go to Walmart, we don't like go to other sections and like buy clothes or anything like that. That's just not something we've ever done. I can see how that would sort of be a problem though. You're walking down the food aisle and like right there's the clothes, or like right there are the electronics. But we've just, I don't know, we never ventured. Like, we spend an hour at the grocery store, like used to, we would spend an hour at the grocery store. It's like we don't need to spend any more time at Walmart. That's not something that's fun to us. So we don't really do that. But then how do you stick to your budget? We try. I mean, you guys see our budget report cards. I know a lot more of you watch the budget than we do the budget report card, but you have to do both in your own budgeting. Because when we first started, our first like 3 or 4 months, we did a budget and then we never looked at it again. We never updated it to see how much we had left in each category. We never revisited it to see if we made more or less money than we were expecting, or if the bill came in higher or lower. We just made the budget and then we just didn't look at it. And we thought we were making a budget, but we weren't following it. It made no sense. So like once I started looking at YouTube videos and stuff like that and seeing people like update on like their mid-month budget update and stuff like that, I was kind of like, oh, okay, so check in with the budget, see how much you have left, and then control yourself and say no. Really, that's the only way, is just we say, okay, we don't have any more money for this. If we spend money on this, we literally will not have money for food. And so, like, if you spend all of your money on bills and then you pay extra toward debt, if you physically don't have any money left in your checking account and no cash in your wallet, you can't go spend extra stuff. So we always try to pay our bills as soon as we get paid. And then any money that we have left is either just for personal food or gas, basically, because those are the only sort of variable expenses that we have. Suzanne, budget-friendly Valentine's ideas. So obviously she asked this question quite a while ago. But for us, just going to a nice dinner that we don't have to cook or going out to a movie is what we do for Valentine's Day a lot of times. I kind of don't even remember what we did this year. I think we were both working because I do not mind working. I love to work because I love to make money because I love to pay off debt. We were kind of both doing that. But for like anniversaries and special occasions, and when we do decide to go out and do something fun, we go out and we walk around downtown and we dress up a little bit and we go look at shops and we see what it has to offer since we're in a new city. And we're kind of like always in a new city. Like, I mean, we lived the last place a year. And so we were still discovering stuff until the very last month, you know. Places are big. We don't mind driving an hour to go to another town to look at that downtown. We do not mind driving at all. So we sometimes just go out driving. We have some beautiful countryside and beautiful mountains that we can go drive through. So that's a lot of fun. We've been hiking a few times together. Probably not as much as Tyler would like, but we've done that before, and that's totally free every time we go, except for the gas to get there, which isn't very much. So, especially since gas prices aren't so crazy anymore, but, that's about all the ideas. So, okay. I think my last question is from Dorota, I believe is her name. I'm sorry if I butchered it. What do we spend our personal money on, and what are some hobbies and some fun things to do? So personal money, Tyler's typically goes to either video games or music. He, like I said, collects vinyl records, so he'll buy music. Sometimes we go to like a concert together. I love live music, so we've done that a few times. Sometimes I just kind of feel like I don't spend my personal money on anything specific because it kind of goes to like food or something like that. Like I'll end up getting like, I don't know, a coffee or something if we're out. I don't do that a whole lot anymore, but I don't know. We haven't had a personal budget in 2 months, so I'm kind of like forgetting what I spend my personal money on. Okay, so my Erin Condren life planner. If I don't have any, like my first two, and like I didn't have any of those referral credits, because every time you click on a link for my Erin Condren Life Planner and you buy one or buy something from the website, you get like that $10 off code. Well, it gives me a $10 credit for every person who goes through my referral link versus just going to the website and buying it. So before I started getting those from you guys, which thank you, by the way, I bought my Erin Condren Life Planner, my phone case. I bought a really expensive phone case because I wanted it, so I saved up a couple months for it. Sleep phones. You guys have seen that sinking fund. They're like headband headphones. I bought those. I bought some like workout earbuds. That's really about it. Like, just kind of things that we sort of like need/want. Like, I don't need workout headphones, but like I kind of like want those more than I want like extra coffee and stuff. So we just kind of like prioritize things like that. But those have been some of the major things that I can sort of think of that I wanted to spend my personal money on. So, okay, that's it for today, guys. Thank you for being patient with me and sticking around for all of the questions. If you have any more, leave them in the description box or in the comment box, and check out all the links below for anything I've mentioned in this video. So take care, guys. I will see you in the next one. Bye.